Today, DJI finally announced their new DJI Mavic 2 Pro and their DJI Mavic 2 Zoom. These hotly anticipated drones did suffer a few setbacks, and leaks have been rampant for the last month. But they're finally here, and we finally know everything there is to know about them. Here's everything you need to know about DJI's new Mavic 2 drones and how they compare to the Mavic Air and Phantom 4. First, let's address price, because I'm going to be honest, I did have sticker shock when I first saw the official product pages. Honestly, I still have sticker shock. The DJI Mavic 2 Pro is going to be retailing for the low price of $1,449, and the Mavic 2 Zoom is going to be selling for a mere $1,249, and they're available right now. For comparison, the DJI Mavic Air starts off at $799, the Phantom 4 Advance goes for $1,199, and the Phantom 4 Pro V2.0 goes for $1,499. A starting price of $1,249 for the Mavic 2 is a significant jump, because the original Mavic Pro started off at a retail price of $999, and the updated Mavic Pro Platinum starts off at $1,099. But if you take all the improvements DJI crammed into their new Mavic 2 drones, I think the new price point is justified. First, let's address what's new on both of these drones. I think the most significant update the new Mavic 2 is rocking is 360-degree obstacle avoidance. This is something I've been calling since the Mavic Air. There's a total of 10 sensors placed all around the body of the drone that basically makes it crash-proof. This is great for a wallet, and it means content creators like myself can focus more on getting the shot instead of not crashing. Because for comparison, the original Mavic Pro could only sense obstacles to its front and bottom, so it was more prone to crashing than the cheaper Mavic Air. Another significant update is the flight time. The two new Mavic 2 drones now have a flight time of 31 minutes, whereas the original Mavic Pro was good for 27 minutes, the Mavic Air is good for 21 minutes, and both Phantom drones are good for 30 minutes. The Mavic 2s can now also reach a max flight speed of 44 miles per hour, 4 miles per hour faster than before, whereas the Mavic Air tops out at 42 miles per hour, and the Phantoms also have a top speed of 44 miles per hour, but from my experience, due to their sheer mass, they're not as nimble as the smaller drones. Transmission systems have also been improved. The new Mavic 2s have AccuSync 2.0. In layman's terms, they're supposed to have a range of up to 8 miles or 8 kilometers. The video feed should be coming in at 1080p instead of 720p like the other drones, and interference is supposed to be less of a problem in densely populated areas. Software-wise, both of these drones also now have advanced optical avoidance like the one that was debuted on the Mavic Air a few months ago. So if you have the Mavic 2 active tracking an object, it's going to be able to automatically dodge obstacles so it can keep the subject in frame instead of just flying in place and losing the subject. Active tracking in general has also been improved. Losing the subject is supposed to be less of an issue thanks to new trajectory prediction algorithms, and you can now active track subjects going as fast as 44 miles per hour. But just be warned, obstacle avoidance systems will be turned off. So those are the new major changes coming to both of the new Mavic 2 drones. 360-degree obstacle avoidance, a 31-minute flight time with quieter propellers, AccuSync 2.0 for a stronger transmission that shouldn't cut out as much and displays your feet in 1080p, and better active tracking. There's a few other goodies like 8 gigs of internal storage, a new dolly zoom quick shot mode, and a few new hyperlapse mode. But here are the main differences between the DJI Mavic 2 Pro and the DJI Mavic 2 Zoom. The DJI Mavic 2 Pro has been improved for better low light performance. It has a 1-inch 20 megapixel CMOS sensor from Hasselblad with an adjustable aperture. Having this 1-inch sensor in the new Mavic 2 Pro is significant, because before, if you wanted a drone with a 1-inch sensor, you had to go with something from the Phantom line. I think that for content creators and YouTubers who want the best possible image quality, the Mavic 2 Pro is the one to get, because it's supposed to be better for low light performance. The DJI Mavic 2 Zoom is rocking a 12 megapixel 1 over 2.3 inch CMOS sensor, which is what you'll find on the outgoing Mavic Pro, the Mavic Air, and even the DJI Spark. But what makes the DJI 2 Zoom special is that it has an optical zoom that can go from 24 millimeters to 48 millimeters. And given with the fact fact that you have up to a 2x lossless digital zoom, the Mavic 2 Zoom can get some really up close pictures without having to get too close to a subject. But now that I think about it, this is the drone for creeps. Just remember, with great power comes great responsibility. When it comes to video capture, things have been slightly improved on the Mavic 2 from the Mavic Pro. Both Mavic 2 drones are going to be able to capture up to 4K video at 30 frames per second, 2.7K up to 60 frames per second, and 1080p up to 120 frames per second. This is the same type of performance we're getting from the Mavic Air. Personally, I was really hoping for 4K 60 frames per second, and maybe even 1080p at 240 frames per second. So overall, there are some significant hardware updates to these new drones that make them much easier to fly than they already were. I feel the 1249 DJI Mavic 2 Zoom is equivalent to an upgraded Mavic Air, which retails for $799. You're getting the same size image sensor and the same video capture rates as the Mavic Air. But the benefits the Mavic 2 Zoom brings to the table is a 31-minute flight time versus 21 minutes and 360-degree optical avoidance. Even though the Mavic Air has really good obstacle avoidance as well, it's still prone to crashing if you're flying from side to side or if you're getting elevation and don't notice a tree branch above it. And I feel paying an extra $450 for the Mavic 2 Zoom is worth it because it's virtually crash proof. It just takes one really bad crash to lose your Mavic Air. And plus, having that optical zoom is a huge advantage. But the Mavic 2 Pro is like having a Phantom drone in the palm of your hand. Even though the Phantom lineup is great, lugging it around is a hassle. But that's not an issue with the Mavic lineup. Even though the Mavic 2 Zoom is still really good and I expect really good image quality from that bad boy, I think content creators are going to love the Mavic 2 Pro because it's going to perform much better in low light environments. If you made it this far, I guess you enjoyed the video, so hit that like button and get subscribed. It helps out more than you realize. Support the channel by clicking on the links down below, and I'll catch you next time.